Hallop.
This is the boulder castle Hallop.
Bombshell Hill. Man, I'm... What is with me today? I'm in like a crazy, stupid mood. How the hell did I not get hit there? You gotta be careful in this area, because everything here explodes, and explosions in this game are incredibly unfriendly. Oh, hey, you can get a mush at the beginning of the stage. That's nice. Mushroom! Da-da-da-da. And a flower. I don't think fire flowers actually do anything to bomb-bombs. No. Which is kind of weird. You'd think they would ignite them, but nope. You want to be careful in these levels, because... the explosions in this game are... Explosions in Thunder Dragon games in general are almost notorious for being... For being highly dangerous. Even for video game explosions. Boy, sure is lucky that actually blew up that block that was blocking this pipe, isn't it? Oh man, I remember this area because I remember getting so frustrated at the torpedo Teds in here, because it was like you can just barely sneak past them horizontally because of your speed. Jeez. Dude, my eyes! I wish they were quick cockjacking. Ah, it hurts. It like literally hurts. You feel like somebody poured wasabi in my eyes. What's burning? Is the fire burning them? That's a quote from the LMAO Mario Party 2 series. Man, that's cool. You come out of that pipe and it's all diagonal. What the fuck? Oh, I bet this is where and this is where the mushroom metal is. Well, hell, there you go. Oh, can I keep going up? Ah, you said cook it up. A little spice. A little thyme. A little salt and pepper. That's salting pepper, not salt and pepper. Oh, there's a platform down there. Don't fall. Ah, I fell. That will never not be funny. Oh, hey, I get a spawn right here. Okay, so I guess I just needed to go down this pipe. Excuse me. Oh, and the level is literally right fucking here. Good thing I died, huh? Jeez. Taking a dump now. I should have checked the audio. Balancing on episode 2 of this. Before I literally stopped the last episode and started this one like 2 seconds later. Should have watched the video to make sure that the balancing was half decent. Anyway, who cares? This wall is only a different color. It must be like that for a reason. Things like this always have a reason. Seriously, but why don't you just try interacting with it? Anyway, so this actually goes into a Shy Guy room with like this random kernel. Like, what's going on there? This is the 8-bit secret hideout. I'll assume you are one of us just because you managed to find this place. But tell me, why aren't you wearing your mask? Are you a Shy Guy without a mask? Is that really what we look like? I've never once taken off my mask, and I was sure every other Shy Guy was like that too. You are weird, man. Got tweesters in here too. Hello, gourmet guy.
There are many other secret passages in the world, but none of them lead to cool places like this. They usually lead to boring things like extra lives and mushroom medals.
And there's the confused Shy Guy. All right, what have we got in the minigame room? Raining blocks. Use your head to keep the falling blocks in the air. It's over if you let even a single block touch the ground. Oh no! Okay, so how bad is this gonna be? Ready? Go! Oh, you know what? You can actually hold shift down to keep jumping. Oh shit! No! Well, I still got 2 lives. That wasn't so bad. That would be a pretty efficient way to grind for lives, considering how fast that minigame ramps up. Anyway, come back here once we have the last mushroom medal of this world, which will probably be in this video, because this is the last level before the boss. Prism Rock.
So pretty. Pretty prism.
Pretty prism would actually... Oh man, I forgot about this music too! But it's not often you hear a remix of like a Yoshi Story song, especially not one that sounds like this. Like a groovy... I wonder if Dr. Fruitcake did this, because that guy does a lot of mini remixes of like like random songs in like different, in like a whole bunch of different styles. What was the one that I found really interesting? I don't remember. Can I go down any of these pipes? I remember when I was a kid, when I was first getting into Super Mario World, I remember thinking that like every time you saw a blue pipe in that game, it meant you'd be able to go into it. And a lot of the time, that was the case. A lot of the time, when you found a blue pipe, you could go into it. But obviously not all the time. Dude, go up. Get up there. Get up. Oh, jeez. Dun, 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 dun. Anyway. Got these numbered note blocks. Oh, jeez. Oh my gosh, a mask Koopa, man. Their heads are so large in this game. It's hilarious. Can I go down your pipe? Nope. Blue pipes lied to me. I love how when the Super Koopas fall to the ground in this game, they look like when a Koopa is climbing on the back of a net in Mario World. Like, that's the sprite they use. I don't remember this level at all. This is weird. I mean, I remember it, but I don't remember. What I would say is that I do remember this world, and it's weird because it's such a weird level. Oh, look at that beautiful gem. I bet the flower ladies in Flower Fields would get a kick out of that. Why was that the first thing I thought of? Because they're my flower waifus, okay? I have no shame. Even though I probably should have some. Is there really nothing here? I want to go up there! Urgh! I missed the mushroom metal, man. Damn it. There's probably just some random pipe you could go down, surely. That has to be it. I didn't think I was that bad at exploring there. Let's try that again. Get to listen to more of that Yoshi's Island, that Yoshi story. Because this looks like Yoshi Cookie. Bop! Oh, sure enough. The second fucking pipe in the hole. What the? Boy, for a second it looked like I was... What the? Oh, that's weird. Oh, that's messed up. Surely I would remember that. That was so weird. Oh, this. This is actually a really interesting little puzzle. You gotta go through this whole area. Pulling up these, like, blocks out of the ground. And then they form, like, a bridge of blocks up at the top that you then have to cross to get to the mushroom metal. So, anyway. I think, though, that I do have to beat the level again. Which kind of sucks. Oh, thank fuck. If I had messed that up, I think that would have been game over. Although, you can press backspace to leave a level. I don't think I'll keep the mushroom metal. But this is where, like, this... Okay, how about... I'll test it. Because that's, like, right at the beginning of the level anyway. So, do I keep the mushroom metal? My bet's on no. Yeah, I don't think so. Alright, I'll meet you when I have it. I'm back! Yeah! Da-da-do. A-do-do. Hey-do. Da-da-do. Anyway. Should wrap this up. Because, I think... My sister's making pizza, and I don't want to be recording when it's nice and hot and ready. Lost Tower. I like how this tower actually spans, like, the whole vertical breast of the level. Like, it goes from the very bottom all the way to the top. Yes, I did mean to say breadth, and yes, I did say breast, just to be controversial. Anyway. Lost Tower! More of the awesome music. Oh, this level. We got booze. But you can actually kill them with a veggie, so that's weird. Anyway, my prostate is the size of a grapefruit. Anywho, that is somewhat obscure and probably not very appropriate reference, but oh well. But anyway, what the? Ah! I'm gonna die! I'm gonna die! I thought I'm gonna die! Oh no! Ah! I'm so dead! I'm so dead! Get away from me! Get away from me! Get away from me! What do you think you're doing? What do you think of me? What are you trying to pull here? I don't know if I know anything about what you're trying to pull here. First of all... Dude! Man, I just like got... That fire bar just grazed my head. It grazed in the location. I only mashed his head. Okay, there we go. That worked well. That worked out. I won't say it worked out well, but it worked out decently enough. Where does this one go? I don't think these... I don't... Yeah, like... jeez. Die. I hate that boo. These boos in this game are so freaking annoying. Oh, did I ever... I never went in there? Oh, that's weird. That's unlike me. I always thought it was weird, too, how, like, the coins you get out of, like, blocks and pulled up from the ground are always red coins. Like, that's weird. Like, why would... Like, why not... Ah, man. Why not blue coins? It's just weird. Where does this one go? This one goes there. Yeah. Where does this one go? This one goes to the hammer. The hammer, hammer, hammer. Release some pressure, but I don't actually want to go that way yet. I'm not supposed to go that way. No. I want to get up here! Okay. Oh, there's nothing here. Never mind. Oh, this is the same door. Okay. That's the same door as the beginning. This one goes there. I think there's like a... Ooh, there's some mush. Yeah, there's a secret over this way, but I can't get to it from here. I can't get there from here. I want a thing. Ha, hang, what, oh. Yeah, I gotta go that. I gotta come at that from a different angle. Even though it's not supposed to go on an angle. You know, sometimes necessity is the mother of invention. Where do I go? Up. Fuck. Up, fuck. I don't know why that was funny. It's just the combination of words up, fuck. Because those are not words that you would typically imagine to exist, you know, to complement each other. Is this just where the boss is? Because I'm going to be pretty chunked up if this is just where the boss is. Oh, here we go. Yeah, this is surely where the mush is. Or where the path to the mush begins. Yeah, there we go. Path to the mush begins. It's like the stupidest. That sounds like a really shitty movie title in like a Mario. Dadgummit. In like a Mario Star Wars ripoff, you know?
Jump again.
Yeah, let's move on here. Don't fall down there, because you'll die, and then you'll be dead. Oh, hey, it's the boss. What a weird place for the boss door, like in this little alcove at the bottom. Anyway, they give you a hammer here, and it's a clubba, or a spike, whatever the fuck you want to call it.
Well, if it isn't that brave little fungus again, here to save the day. I'm surprised you are still in one piece. Oh well, Spike will fix that up in a sec.
Man, what a victorious, like, he's going Super Saiyan. Oh no, he really is Super Saiyan. He's got a ponytail of rainbows. He's like Lemmy Koopa. Weird post-reboot. He's like weird reboot Lemmy Koopa. Yeah, just hit, you gotta hit the ground to launch this guy. Man, I can't, oh man. That is, thank you. Making me nervous, man. Tell you what, man. Oh, these are terrible. This guy's pretty easy, though. No problem. That was a pretty slick jump over. I didn't even know it was possible to jump over him. Man, that guy's easy. I can't believe how easy that guy is. I remember that guy being, like, really hard when I was a kid. Like, I remember not, like, just dying over and over. I can just imagine, like, Mario, Luigi, Toad, and Yoshi, like, all holding vaudeville canes and wearing top hats, like, dancing back and forth, doing that thing where you, like, grab the cane in both hands and, like, jack it forward and backward as you, like, dance your legs up and down and you're all diagonal in a row, you know? It's just so stupid. I had to use the word jack, didn't I? Anyway. What's this? I don't even remember what the secret stage is for this world. This game doesn't really have guides online anywhere. I swear there was a guide that you could get in like a Word document at some point. but hell if I remember where it is. Okay, what's the level? Freak Zone. Well, that's not very nice. Well, that wasn't very Christmassy of him. Anyway. Oh my gosh, look at these fucking, look at that fucking veggie. Oh, I got this music though. Man, look at this cuck-a-feeling inducing palette. Are you scoping this choice cuck-a-feeling in this area? First of all, you know, magenta to purple gradient on the floor, I adore. You know, the dark blue spacey background, the maroon, you know, the doo-doo maroon background, and look at these pipes! Oh, we got Hammer Bros, though. That's no fun. Hammer Bros in this game are weird. They don't act like any Hammer Bro I've ever known. And you can't kill them with fire! I didn't remember that. Every single time I take a hit. Anyway. I don't remember this level at all. This is weird. Maybe I never actually got... Oh, you know what? I bet there's a Yosh in here. Well, never mind, you have to hold your nose. What is the purpose? Do I have to eat all the... Ah, don't fall! Yeah, you can... Yeah, so there's sniffers in this game, and they make a weird noise when they're about to shoot. They, like, go... You know? Like somebody sucking in air through their teeth. Through their teeth. The character from Final Fantasy VI, whose real name is Sabin, but I always called him Teeth when I named the characters myself, and it's so stupid. Okay, so this is... Hell. Fuck. Man, but he still ate it. He ate it from beyond the grave. Oh, I gotta do this whole shit again. It's like, I was looking up Thanks, I Hate It on Google, looking for, like, where that phrase was first used. The one that I remembered was from somebody posting the skeleton of an owl. Or, like, what an owl would look like without any feathers, and it was, like, a horrible nightmare creature, and the reply was, Thanks! I hate it! But I was looking that up, and I found a post that was... It was, take a shot every time somebody opens a present on Christmas and says, Oh, wow, I got a box! But they typoed and it said, take a shit. Take a shit every time. I am 8 years old. I swear. What is with these gooey balls? I remember that. I remember those gooey mounds. Dude, the palette in this area is gorgeous. I fucking love it. I want that. I don't care what's in that question mark. I want it. It's a mush! Come back to me, mushy! Re-arrive. Oh man, Yoshi can't eat Hammer Bros? That seems arbitrary. I've seen Yoshi eat more than that. I have a lot more hair than that! Name that game. What? What? Holy crap. Okay. I'm scared. Don't hold your nose. Oh, do I have to get all the red coins or all the stars? I don't know. I can't believe there's a time limit in here. Why, this is scary. Dude, I can't, I'm panicking. And I'm playing like shit because of it. Okay, seriously. You already opened up the roof. Just get in there and get the red coin. Dude, you're a failure. You're a jailer. You're an idiot. Get the red coin and jump over here. I don't even care if I get hit by the piranha pants. Fuck. Dude, die! Oh my gosh! Ugh. Jeez. Making me nervous, man! What the hell was that?! Oh, the music looped. That was funny. Okay, now get over there. Get over there. Get over there. Now. Just take a nice... You know, take a... Oh, are you kidding me? Oh, it's coming down. Come back, Boone! What? What the hell is all this? Thank you. Open the door. Open the door, Yang! Okay, anyway, sorry. Oh, with a freak zone. Man, look at these veggies! He's like,
What is that over there?
Open the door, Yang! Man, name that game. Well, that's pretty easy, because it's right there in the name of the character. Not the name of the game, but, like, anybody who knows that name is gonna know instantly what game I'm talking about. Counterintuitively enough, the only weapon of yours that can actually kill a dry bones or a hammer throw is, I love when that happens. Sometimes the fireball isn't destroyed when it hits a piranha plant, and it just keeps going through all the piranha plants in a row. It feels so good. Oh man, I forgot about that. At the very end of Freak Zone, there's no mushroom in these stages. It's a virus, and you gotta be careful here. Because he, well, I think I might actually be about to die here. Because he keeps lighting these fucking patches of grass on fire, and you have to, like... Yeah, like, I don't know how the hell you're supposed to do that. Like, you can't knock him back far enough. Maybe if you just jumped over him, like jumped over him to the other side of him and then lured him away from the fiery grass, that would probably work. Thanks for the... A bit generous with the checkpoints, don't you think? I mean, did you really need to put a checkpoint there? That's like right at the end of the stage before this like simple mini boss that you can basically tank this mini boss as long as you have at least 2 health or at least 3 health. Okay, so here, just jump over him. What the? Okay, maybe not. Yeah, you know what? I'm just gonna tank the hits. I don't know if it's even possible to... I mean, the guy in the video, I watched a guy who beat all the bosses in the game, and he did this, but I don't see how that would even be possible. But, if you knock him into there, he dies, so whatever. And there you go, there's the switch. Yee-hey! Man, we're up to 22 minutes, I gotta end this video, man! Holy cow! Holy crap, man! Yay, so happy.
I'm so, so happy, you're so stupid! It's like that's the only word in your vocabulary or something. And my voice is cracking like crazy.
Wow. It really was there for a second. Jeez. Okay, anyway. Boy, did you see that? That was freaking awesome. That was like the most slick egg. That was like the most slick exit out of that world I think I've ever done. So anyway, next time on Toad Strikes Back, we will move on to World 3, Radiant Resort. Summer fun and beach babes await. Next time.
Da-da-da! Bam!